Well, hospitals have made several changes in the wake of the swine flu outbreak.
But brand new suggestions from one report may be stepping over the line. We have team coverage of the swine flu. Tracy Potts has a national look at the outbreak and the new data just released from the Centers for Disease Control. But we start with West 2's Gail Pascoe Brown and a plan for hospitals that could be even worse news for terminally ill patients. Gail?
Well, this is the report, the 33-page report, and it is a plan. It is a draft. It is not etched in stone. Pandemic influenza triage and scarce resource allocation guidelines. It's for hospitals and other medical personnel in case of a worst-case scenario, pandemics.
We're able to clean the wounds properly here. We're able to close them appropriately.
During Hurricane Katrina, parts of New Orleans came down to this, MASH units to care for victims of the devastating storm. Similar is the reason behind Florida's draft guidelines, patient triage, who will get treatment and who won't when demand for medical resources exceeds supply. Seminole County EMS Director Dr. Todd Husty. Well,
this is not H1N1. This is if we have the type flu that starts killing thousands and tens of thousands and millions, then you have to make a decision. We're not going to have to do this, hopefully, this year.
The Florida plan guides hospitals on how to ration scarce medical care, which calls for turning away some patients, for example, who are terminally ill, to treat others.
In New Orleans, they actually had an instance with one of the hospitals that they were doing something very similar to this. I talked to the doctors that were there, and as far as I'm concerned, they were heroes because they had to make some horrible, horrible decisions. I mean, very, very difficult decisions. I don't know how I'd do it.
Florida's Surgeon General says this should not be misconstrued as a plan for the current H1N1 flu. This draft document is a supplemental guidance to Florida's pandemic influenza plan that began in 2006 and continues to evolve. The state Surgeon General says the final version will be completed after input from stakeholders and the public. Now, I did speak with spokespersons from here, from Florida Hospital, as well as Orlando Health. They are not commenting on these guidelines because it is what it is, a plan. It is not finalized. I'm Gail Pascoe Brown reporting in Orlando for West 2 News.